What makes this good news? Is this good news because, well, it is good news because it brings about an encounter with God. That's what the good news is about. Did you notice the misspelling? God news. There was a prep school where the children put up, you know, they put up a message there, quoting from Luke chapter 4, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He has anointed me to bring bad news to the poor. And the teacher said, children, that is a misspelling. It's supposed to be good, not God. And the children said, no, ma'am, it's not misspelling, because it's good because it comes from God. And He's telling us God news. And how right the children were. It is only good news because it is an encounter with God. When you're not able to lead people to an encounter, a personal encounter with God, you cannot be bringing good news. Well, good news is an experience of God's forgiveness, God's healing, God's peace, God's power, God's presence. It is good news to the poor. You want to hear the good news? You have to be poor. Because good news is for the poor. The poor are the privileged recipients of the good news of Jesus. Poverty here is a disposition. An important disposition if you want to hear the good news. Because good news can become bad news for those not disposed for it. And that can only mean those who are not poor. Example. You remember that young man? Can you please read that? Isn't that funny? Why should he go away sad? He had many possessions. You would expect modern society to read, oh, he went away very happy because he was very rich. No, no. Wealth is not always bringing happiness to all people. This particular man went away sad. And that's the good news. It's good news precisely because he's sad. If he's happy, that's bad news. But it is good news because he's sad. That's why Jesus looked at him with love. Because now he is discovering the emptiness of his dependence on material wealth. That's positive. That's positive. And so, let me end with Francis of Assisi. Francis of Assisi is my image of that rich young man who was sad despite his many possessions. The joy of the gospel set him free from the prison of sadness and grief. Please. At the time when the church had deteriorated into a pile of ruins, and you see during the time of Francis, the church hierarchy had become intoxicated with power. Popes and cardinals were kings and princes. Well, there are still, you know, people like that. And I'm sure that not a single one of our cardinals in this country behaves like a prince or a king. You agree? Yes, thank you, Cardinal Rivera, you heard that. It was a time of deterioration, a time of collapse for the church, a spiritual deterioration. And Francis got a mandate. Francis, would you rebuild my church? It was a time when people had gotten used to proclaiming a gospel without joy. It's not gospel if it is not with joy. And so, you remember that scene in Brothers and Sisters Room? The old chair. Stripped to his various necessities and free from his superfluity, she discovers a hidden treasure, a pearl of great price. Now that he has been stripped, now that he has found his nakedness before God, he is clothed again, which is what baptism is about. Remember St. Paul saying that? I remind you, brothers and sisters, to allow yourselves to be clothed with compassion and kindness, humility, gentleness, bearing one another lovingly. Now he's clothed again by the grandeur of nature, taking from the words of the gospel. Can we read that together? And yet, next, yet, that's how the gospel came to Francis. Looking at the birds here, looking at the lilies of the fields. It was poverty that made Francis discover true wealth that brought him closer to nature. And closer to kinship to the elements. The joy of the gospel made Francis discover his kinship, relationship to the elements, relationship to nature. And he started calling the sun his brother and the moon his sister. He started calling the wind his brother, that's the air his sister. And you remember the song from Brother, Sun, Sister, Moon. Brother, Sun, Sister, Air, open my eyes to vision pure and fair. Can we read that together? I feel his love awakening in my heart. Together? Awakening. We have to be awakened to be able to see the beauty around us, to be able to see the hand of God, and to be able to feel the joy of the gospel. From St. Francis to Pope Francis, I think Pope Francis is delivering the same timeless message of the gospel. Jesus, Francis of Assisi, Pope Francis. He is delivering this gospel, especially for people who pursue wealth but end up living a shallow, meaningless, joyless existence of broken relationships. Broken relationship with nature, with one another, with God. Losing a sense of God's amazing grace, which alone awakens faith in us. It is love that awakens faith. That is why it is the greatest of all gifts. Faith, hope, and love, but the greatest is love. The beginning of evangelization is the awakening of love, the discovering that we are loved by God unconditionally. Pope Benedict gave a beautiful definition of faith. He says, faith is the human ability to respond to the God who speaks to us. How can you respond if you didn't first of all listen? Faith is the human ability to love the God who loved us first. How can you love him back if you didn't first of all discover that God loved us first? That's the amazing grace. It's an awakening to God's love, awakening the sweet sound of God's voice, and awakening the sweet sound of God's amazing grace. This is what the joy of the gospel is about. Amen. Thank you. I signaled that to be the ending. A joy that amazes. You remember the song? I once was lost, but now I'm found. Some people don't sing that properly. They say, I once was lost, but now I'm found. No, you don't say, I found. I am found. It's in the passive voice. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I'm found. Meaning I did not find him. He found me. That's the joy of the gospel. Amen. Yeah. Like the lost sheep whom the shepherd did not give up on. Imagine yourself as the lost sheep. And you're there hanging on the precipice. You had fallen on a cliff. And the shepherd had been looking for you everywhere. And you're helpless, hanging on for dear life. And then you heard a voice that called you by name. And then you cried out and said, Ba, Ba. And then he followed the sound and looked from the precipice like that, and he said, Oh my, you are there, thank heavens. And he goes down and picks you up and puts you on his shoulder, and he is jumping and leaping with joy. Just when you thought he had given up on you. Because remember, you got lost. It was your fault. But he's not blaming it on you. He's still joyful. Just when you thought he had left you to die in the cold, dark night, well, you suddenly hear his voice, which makes you realize he had not stopped looking for you. You were blinded, but now you see. You see the shepherd's joy. There you are on the shoulder of the shepherd. And you're looking at the face of the shepherd, and he's beaming with joy. And he's now bringing you home. Can we end with that joy by singing together Amazing Grace?
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, thoughts, and snares, I have already come. Was grace that brought us saved thus far, and grace will lead me home.
Yes, grace will lead us all home. Amen. Thank you.
Coming up on stage right now.
Are you an Espana person?
The one you are.
How are you? Why hello?
Blessings after
people. Blessings after people say, what is your name?
Mary
Colleen. Mary Colleen. Hello, Mary Colleen. What can I do for you?
This is my question. Paano po ay papahalal ang mabuting balita, the gospel of joy, at ipapakilala si Jesus sa iba
and you know, cause of sanctification. So the beginning of the experience of that joy is humility. I think that is what conversion is about. You know, see, John the Baptist was calling metanoia. And about faith, believing not in our own strength and power, but in the strength and power of God at work in us. And it has to begin with a recognition of our own littleness and inadequacy, which is what the sacrament of reconciliation is inviting us to experience. Alam mo yung reconciliation, ang ganda niyan. Ang point is the best formula for situations of conflict, especially yung mga kanyang kapatahan. Madalas yung experience yung ganyan parang broken relationships. And Jesus gives us that formula, the humility to confess, meaning to admit. I think if we don't have that humility to admit our shortcomings, hihirapan tayo gawin yung gospel. Confession, contrition, or CCC, no? The humility to say, we've caused misery on other people, that's why now we feel misery. And the third is penance, reparation, to be able to make amends for what we've done. And the absolution, you know, almost goes without saying.